Hi, welcome once again. In this video we will see what is Fresnel material expressions. Oftentimes when creating a film or cinematic, you need a way to better highlight the silhouette of a character. This lighting technique is often referred to as rim lighting or edge lighting, and involves adding additional lights to help better distinguish the character's silhouette from the background. While this works quite nicely for film, adding additional lights to any 3D scene adds extra complexity that can quickly become difficult to manage. Unreal Engine offers a solution to this by allowing artists to simulate the same basic effect using the material of the character. This way, the artist has more control over the look and feel of the effect and can even use it for things like adding lighting to an unlit object to save on performance. Fresnel is the term used to describe how the light you see reflects at different intensities based off of the angle you are viewing it from. In Unreal Engine, the Fresnel Material Expression node calculates a falloff based on the dot product of the surface normal and the direction to the camera. When the surface normal points directly at the camera, a value of 0 is output, meaning there should be no Fresnel effect happening. When the surface normal is perpendicular to the camera, a value of 1 is output, meaning the full effect of the Fresnel should be taking place. The result is then clamped to 0 and 1, so you do not have any negative color in the center. The following image demonstrates this concept. In the middle of the sphere, where the 0 is, you will see that there is no Fresnel effect. This is because the camera is pointing directly at the surface normal. As the surface normal becomes more and more perpendicular to the camera, or getting closer and closer to the number 1, the Fresnel effect becomes more and more visible, and this is the type of behavior we want. When searching for the Fresnel material expression, you will find that there is a Fresnel under Utility and one under Vector Ops. While these two material expressions have the same name and do the same thing, they do differ in how you set them up for use. First, check Fresnel Utility. The Fresnel that is found under Utility is the one that is used in this how-to and is the simplest one out of the two to set up and use. So the exponent in controls the falloff of the Fresnel effect. The base reflect effraction in specifies the fraction of specular reflection when the surface is viewed from straight on. Setting this to a value of 1 effectively disables Fresnel and the normal as, where you can input a normal to affect the way the Fresnel effect is rendered. This property cannot be set by supplying either a normal map or a vector 3 input. You have two options for adjusting the values for the Fresnel material expression. Select the Fresnel material expression in the material graph and then input values via the details panel. Add constant or scalar nodes to the material graph and then hook them up the respective inputs. When using a normal map, make sure to add a transform expression node. This will transform the normal map from tangent space into world space. If this transform is not performed, your normal map might not influence the Fresnel the way you intend. Now let's check the Fresnel Vector Ops. The Fresnel that is found under Vector Ops is a highly customizable version of Fresnel that allows you to affect many different aspects of how the Fresnel is rendered. However, this added functionality has its drawbacks, as incorrect settings or setup could lead to artifacts or errors in how the Fresnel effect is rendered. This node should only be used if the Fresnel that is under Utility does not yield the results you're looking for. So let's see how we can use the Fresnel in Material. Add some base node, and when completed, your material graph should look like this. Once this has been done, the parameter can then be edited. For example, if you enable the Fresnel parameter, you can increase or decrease the effect the Fresnel has on the surface. Remember that inputting bigger numbers into Fresnel underscore express will push the Fresnel effect closer and closer to the edges, and lower numbers will bring the effect closer to the center. Here is an example of what happens to the Fresnel when the Fresnel expo value is to different values. Notice how as the number increases, the Fresnel effect is pushed closer and closer to the edges of the mesh, like in the following example. Now let's see how you can add normal map and defile the Fresnel effect. If you input a normal map into the normal input of the Fresnel, you will see that you can affect the surface in a number of very interesting ways. This is because of the normal map's influence over the surface normal. As we learned before, the Fresnel works by checking to see if the surface normal is perpendicular to the camera or not. If it is perpendicular to the camera, then the Fresnel effect will take place. On a smooth sphere, this means that the Fresnel will only take place at the edges of object. However, when a normal map is introduced, we change the surface normal to no longer be smooth, allowing the Fresnel effect to happen in places that it normally would not if the surface normal had been smooth. For a visual example of what is going on, take a look at the following image showing the effect the surface normal has on the Fresnel. On the left is what the Fresnel node will output with a flat surface normal. Now take a look at the right-hand side. In this image, a normal map was input which drastically changes the surface normal. Because the surface normal is no longer flat everywhere, you get more of the Fresnel being displayed. In the image below, we can see how different normal maps can affect the Fresnel in different ways. The material that was used to create the images above was the same material that was created before but with the following modifications made. A new 2D texture sampler was added and plugged into the normal input. The Fresnel material expression can also be supplied with a normal map that can affect the way the Fresnel is rendered. This is particularly useful if you want to use the Fresnel to display something like an energy shield on a material but still have that material look normal when the shield is not active. To achieve this using the material above, the following things need to be done. First, start by updating the translucency lighting mode by changing it from volumetric non-directional to surface translucency volume. Then change the base color and roughness parameters. Next, change the normal input so that it uses t_brick_clay_n, which can also be found in the starter content. Next, search for a transform expression node in the palette and add it to the material graph. Make sure that it is set to transform from tangent to world space. Now connect the old normal map texture node into the input of the transform node and connect its output into the normal input on the Fresnel node, and when completed, your material should look something like this. Notice how the bricks look like they have nothing to do with the Fresnel. You can even take this one step by adding a multiply and constant expression node and then using that to control the intensity of Fresnel effect. Here is how that would look when added to the material from above. By adjusting the constant that was added, you can control how the Fresnel affects the surface. Setting the number to 0 turns off the effect, and setting it to anything else will gradually reveal the effect like in the example below. Let's see other uses for Fresnel. Due to the way Fresnel works, it can be used to do other things besides just rim lighting. Here are some examples of using the Fresnel node to do other things than just rim lighting. Input blending: you can use the Fresnel as the alpha for a lerp to control how inputs to the lerp are combined together. Adding Fresnel to a material is a great way to help better illuminate a character's silhouette or to help show an energy shield special effect. Remember that Fresnel works based off of viewing angle and surface normals, so if you want to add some interesting detail to the Fresnel, try using a normal map that has a little random noise in it. Also, do not forget that you can use Fresnel material expression to help blend between two different inputs, which is very handy for visual effects like fire or smoke. Hope from this video, you will start to move into building in more advanced mechanics, in an easy to follow step-by-step approach, which will allow you to play around and build your own content, to eventually build your own game. Thanks a lot, see you in the next video.